So now let me see about the vesical channel or vesical meridian or the vesical Qing Lo. Qing means is the meridian, is the pathway. The connectivity is called as a Luo. That is called as a communication. That's called as a nexary, right? Interior and exterior. Now let's we start from the point which we called as a Qingming. It starts from the inner canthus of the eye. It ascends upward direction to the forehead. From the forehead, it ascends again to the top of the vertex of the head. Again, it descends the downwards direction on the popliteal, descends to the occipital region. From the occipital region, again, it is the very lateral part of the vertebral column. It descends the downwards direction to the gluteal region. From the gluteal region, finally, it communicates to the popliteal fossa. That's called as a UB40. There, the energy gets terminated. The another ramification or branch starting from the neck region, that is UB10 region. From there, it descends the downwards direction is the medial side of the, or we call as a, is the lateral side of the vertebrae, so medial side of the scapula. So that descends the downwards direction and communicating to the lower gluteal muscles, and from the gluteal muscles again it descends the downwards direction and communicating and meeting at UB40. So the other ramification, the third ramification of the branch, descends the downwards direction from the UB40. Then again it descends on the posterior side of the leg through the gastrocnemius muscles and soleus muscles, and then lateral malleolus. From the lateral malleolus and the border of the metatarsal bone, so it finally terminates the energy on the psi-in area, that is the lost pinky toe on the lateral margin. So this is the superficial pathway. Now you can understand the whole pathway, where it starts from the vision, from the, it covers the forehead and it covers the temporal head and the vertex of the head and descends the occipital head and the whole back in the both the ways bilaterally, in the symmetrical way. It covers the entire spectrum of the vertebrae and descends the downwards direction and communicating both the hips region and then hamstring muscles and communicating both the knees, and from the knees it descends the downwards direction. What I mean to say, exactly the 67 points, right, 134 points are existing in our body, only belongs to the urinary bladder meridian. So since the points are located bilaterally, 67 is the unilateral, the other, both the sides are 134 points, right? So now what I mean to say, exactly the whole spectrum of the diseases can be covered by activating these points. From the top to toe, from the head to toe, what are the indications, which includes the sense organ, which includes the central nervous system, which includes the peripheral nervous system, which includes sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system and ganglias, different kinds of the ganglias, which is communicating to connecting to the internal organs, right? Since the most of the back shoe inductories or the points are located only on the vesical meridian, no other meridian having the total 12 points, especially which is located on the back shoe points. So no, none of the meridians are existing like that, except the next meridian, which we call as the Ren Mai meridian or the conceptional vessel meridian. But first of all, this is the biggest meridian, the biggest pathophysiology, and certainly the most of the diseases can be treatable by activating the vesical meridian organ. So therefore, we look at that step by step, the point to point, and what are the physiology and where the exactly the points are located, what are the significant and qualification of the each and every acupuncture point, right? So let me start the beginning of the first point, which we called as a Qingming. UB1 point to be called as a Qingming. That point is located on the inner canthus of the eye. You just look at the white dot, so very close to the eye. That point is located the inner canthus of the eye. You understand, this is the inner, this is the outer canthus of the eye, right? The point is located in the inner canthus. This point, really good point, since it is communicating to the three arteries. So what are those arteries? One is the angular artery, ophthalmic artery, and then lacrimal artery. There are the three arteries are communicating to the one point, and also the stomach and the small intestine is meeting point, which we called as a jingming. Right? Jingming denotes here is the brightening of the eyes in the Chinese. So therefore, this point is always is good to treat for the various diseases like the lacrimation, where the tears are coming continuously, and also the retina related conditions where the black spots and shadows are coming in front of the eyes, and so on. Known and unknown cases of the vision related disturbances can be treatable by activating this point. But however, this point is very vulnerable point and dangerous point. We should not insert the needle, but only the experts can apply this needle. But in the beginners, is not recommended to use this point. But however, you cannot do moxibustion also, but you can do only by giving the pressure by using the index finger. You just give the pressure in this way, bilaterally activating this point. So that means under the bridge of the nose, and you just activate this point by giving the pressure in the upward direction, right? But you should not touch inside the orbit that you are, you know, doing some kind of the nerves. So you should not damage them. So therefore, gently you just massage this point or knead this point in the clockwise direction and anti-clockwise direction. This really good for the most of the vision related disorders, especially for the retina related conditions. The people who are suffering for the retina pigmentosa, this is the very rare cases will happen. Even, you know, night blindness or day blindness, you know, all these things also can be taken care by activating this point. Right, the second most important point to be called as a UB2, that point is Sansu. So this point is located on the medial end of the eyebrow. Bilaterally the point is located. This point is really good to activate the various diseases related to the vision as well. But how to do this? Generally it is required to do the puncture. So when you look at the micro level, there is a hole. There is a hole exactly on Sansu point UB2 that you just insert by doing the sterilized lancet. You just take it and then puncture bilaterally to clear the most of the vision related disturbances. Right? Now I told you you should not do the needling to the UB1. At the same time UB2 can be given. UB2 you can apply the needle. So how to do that procedure, I'll suggest you. You just apply the needle from the UB2 to UB1 in the descending direction. I think that will be good if you wanted to treat both the points, which we call as a through to through needling. So now I applied on UB2 point. So this UB2 point, either you can puncture, that can be recommended for the desirable results, or you just insert the needle. So that needle is entering towards the inner canthus of the eye. So that indicates that's a good point to treat for the both the conditions, for the UB2 and then UB1 having the synergy effect. You understand, this is the supraorbital nerve, supraorbital artery. This also will support to that ophthalmic artery, right? So however, this point, both the points are good to treat, not only for the vision. Of course, this point is good to treat for the trigeminal neurology as well, and also the frontal sinusitis, where there is the kind of the stagnation and the retention of the, which we call as the insubstantial phlegm, which is accumulated on the frontal sides. Even for that condition, certainly bilaterally we can use this point to treat for the sinus related conditions, nasal blockages and polyps inside the nose. All these things can be treated by activating this particular point. Better don't use UB1, UB2 is recommended. That to use horizontal level, that descending on the downwards direction, that goes to the, you know, inside, that is deeply has gone to the closer to the inner canthus of the eye. Right, now we look at the third point, which we call as a Meechum. That point is located 0.5 chun above the anterior hairline and 0.5 chun away from the midline of the anterior hairline. Now you look at the center of this, This is called as a glabella, extra one point, and this is the anterior hairline. But don't see here, the anterior hairline should be, this is the anterior hairline. That means 3 chun proximal from the glabella, mid of the eyebrows. From the eyebrow you just place and where the 4 fingers ends. So that to be called as the anterior hairline, right? Not this hairline, but where the origin of the hairs starts, that is the hairline. From there 0.5 chun above from the anterior hairline, vertically above the UB2. You just look at the image, vertically above the UB2, the point is located V-chun. So that point is really good to treat for the various conditions related to the nasal related disorders, especially the epistaxis, that called as the bleeding from the nose, or the nose related disorders which we call as anosmia. Even anosmia, that is the olfactory bulb which will going to block sometimes, that causes the loss of smell. Even this COVID conditions, the people have the anosmia conditions, even that also can be treatable by activating to the Mi Chung point, right? So that point to be used when you go from here and then here, half chun above from the posterior hairline, vertically above this. If you wanted to treat, you can treat by activating this point towards the nose. Is in the horizontal direction towards the nose. If the person is suffering for the problem of the temporal headache or the frontal headache, better you apply towards the energy flow, you can activate that point, or the nose related disorders can be treatable by activating this point. But however, the beauty of this point, even for the wrinkles on the forehead also can be treatable by activating this point. UB3 Vichung point to be activated bilaterally towards the downwards direction for the wrinkles of the forehead. Wrinkle of the glabella can be treatable by activating UB Chung. Right? The fourth point is Chun Chai. So that point is located 1 chun lateral to the UB3 and half chun above the posterior, half chun above the anterior hairline. The point is Chun Chai. Chun Chai is the UB4 point. That point is exactly that also treatable for the nose related and also the frontal head related disorders. So in fact the 4, 5, 6, 7, so these are the points are treatable for the supraorbital artery, supraorbital nerve, so which is the communicating to the ophthalmic artery, right? This is the branch of the arteries which is helping directly, indirectly to the forehead and also for the head and also for the vision as well. So therefore UB4, the point is good to treat as a local point. You can treat for the numerous diseases as per the Yamamoto new scalp acupuncture. So this point is good point to treat for the vision also, right? Because of there are the three sense organs are located, so exactly this above the nose. So which we call as the first point is the nose, and first point is the eye, the second point is the nose, and third is the lips, right? And both the sides, this point which we call as a ears, so as per the Yamamoto. But however, this also like a acupuncture meridian pathway, no doubt. At the same time, this also covers for the scalp acupuncture as well. So therefore this also covering for the supraorbit artery and the branches of the ophthalmic arteries which is covering, so that also indicating this point is good to treat for the vision as well, right? Now when we look at that, 4th and 5th point is located Uchu. That point is half chun above from the UB4, half chun above from the UB4. That point is good point to treat for the, of course, is the frontal headache, especially for the frontal sinusitis. That conditions can be treatable. But however, 6 and 7, this point is 1.5 chun posterior to the UB5, and then UB6 point is UB7 point is located 1.5 chun posterior from the UB6. So therefore this point is UB5 is only the 0.5 chun, and UB6 and 7 points are 1.5 chun posterior, 1.5 chon posterior, and UB8 the point is 1.5 chon posterior. You understand UB5 and 6 are good point generally as a local point having the local effect. The other point UB7, which we call as a tumtian, so that point is really good to treat for the various condition of the nose related disorders. You understand? I told you the olfactory bulb. So this point also the olfactory bulb point, and this point also covering for the olfactory bulb point, where the anosmia conditions can be treatable, the point called as a tumtian. UB6 is jequam, UB7 is tumtian, UB8 is locho. So that point is again 1.5 chun posterior to the UB7. Understand, UB8 the point is very good point to treat for the pineal gland. Right, the pineal gland, we all know it is related to the, you know, third eye. Right, so in fact this is a very good point in order to overall improve and induce the natural sleep. Since this particular point is inducing the melatonin hormone, which is essential for the normal sleep. So we know that dopamine also good hormone, which is essential to inducing the natural sleep, and also which we call as a happy hormone. At the same time, melatonin is the most important to induce the natural sleep. So therefore, do you know the DU20? The Paihui, the point is located very closer to this, the Thum Luchu and then Paihui, DU20. Both the points are located very closer to each other. That point are producing the melatonin, which is essential for the natural sleep and which is activating to the pineal gland. Even the pineal gland activation, the point which we called as intang. Intang, the point is located midway between the two eyebrows. This point to be called as intang. That's really good to treat for the various kinds of the thought process and emotional conditions, and also in order to improve the overall the consciousness and to inducing the natural sleep, and also the cognitive functions and memory as well. Right? So UB8 you have seen. The UB9 point is Yuzen. So that point is located 2.5 chun proximal, that means above from the posterior hairline, and 1.3 chun lateral to the posterior midline. Now you can see the image also. Now you can see when you touch and feel, this is the osteoid cross occipital bone. When you come down, once you come down, you can find the depression after the mastoid process, right? So once you come down where it ends, so there is the point. That means from this is the posterior midline, this is the posterior hairline. From here 1.3 chun, 1.3 chun lateral to the posterior midline, right? And then vertically below the occipital protuberance. When you wanted to know from here, you understand this is the posterior hairline, 2.5 chun above from the posterior hairline, where there is the end, lower portion of the occipital protuberance, that point you will get the UB9, that point called as a Yuzen. That point is really functioning point for the pons. The pons point is UB9, and then UB10 point is Tiansu. So that point is 1.3 chun lateral to the posterior hairline, right, on the midline. So 0.5 chun above the posterior hairline, and then 1.3 chun lateral to the posterior midline. You understand what is the posterior hairline? See, this is the posterior hairline. So what hairline? The people are hairs are very growth, and you know too much hairs are there, you cannot count where is the posterior hairline. You take this hairs upward direction. Once you take this hairs, then where you can find the line, the hairs starts or where the hairs ends. So that ending hairs which we call as a posterior hairline, right? The posterior midline, anterior posterior midline. So this is the anterior, and then posterior is the back midline. From here to here, this is the anterior posterior midline. This is the anterior hairline, and this is the posterior hairline, right? So now the UB10 points is good point, really it's an amazing and wonderful point. So among these points, the UB2 and then UB3, UB7 and UB8 and UB9-10. These points are really crucial points, you understand. UB10 is the Tianzhu, that point is located, I told you, 1.3 chun lateral to the posterior midline and then 0.5 chun above from the posterior hairline, where the atlas and axis, there are the two bones are there. Atlas is the first cervical vertebra, the axis is the second cervical vertebra. Midway between these two, the point is located, right? So this point is really good to treat for the numerous diseases related to the cervical pain, where the trapezius muscles is the origin, right? There the point is located, that point is, you can look at the image here also. So this point is good to treat for the not only the cervical pain, but it includes the occipital headache and also the cervical spondylopathy, spandical, you know, radiculopathy and a myelopathy and all the, you know, anything related to the occipital region which is communicating to the vision also. You know the visual cortex where is located, same that proximal to that UB10, the points are located, that's called as a visual cortex. So once you activate bilaterally, you understand GB20 and UB10, if you apply the pressure on the left side, that communicates to the right eye. When you apply this point through the right side, that communicates to the left eye. So therefore, in fact, this point is really good to treat for the vision and numerous related conditions which is related to the central nervous system. Even my Laoshas told me that this GB20 Fench and then Tianzhu, this point is communicating to the brain where the UB meridian started here and finally it is converges to the central nervous system, especially the brain. So therefore the whole spectrum, the cerebral cortex, the cerebrum and all the pons and medulla oblongata, it covers the entire spectrum because of the one hemisphere is communicating to the right side of the pon, the other side and the left side of the hemisphere is communicating all these acupuncture points. So therefore this point till the UB10, the points are really good to treat for the numerous diseases related to the head related conditions, right?